as there are stars in a typical galaxy. The same is true for dogs and bears and every living thing. We are, each of us, a little universe. The DNA message handed down from cell to cell and from generation to generation is copied with extreme care. The birth of a new DNA molecule begins when an unwinding protein separates the two strands of the double helix, breaking the rungs apart. Inside the liquid of the nucleus, the molecular letters of the genetic code float freely. Each strand of the helix copies its lost partner, resulting in two identical DNA molecules. That's how life reproduces genes and transmits them from one generation to the next. When a living cell divides in two, each one takes away with it a complete copy of the DNA. A specialized protein proofreads to make sure that only the right letters are accepted so that the DNA is accurately copied. But nobody's perfect. Occasionally, a proofreading error slips through, making a small random change in the genetic instructions. A mutation has occurred in the bear's egg cell. A random event as tiny as this one can have consequences on a far grander scale. That mutation altered the gene that controls fur color. It will affect the production of dark pigment in the fur of the bear's offspring. Most mutations are harmless. Some are deadly. But a few, purely by chance, can give an organism a critical advantage over the competition. A year has passed. Our bear is now a mother. And as a result of that mutation, one of her two cubs was born with a white coat. When the cubs get old enough to venture out on their own, which bear is more likely to be able to sneak up on unsuspecting prey? The brown bear can be seen against the snow a mile away. The white bear prospers and passes on its own particular set of genes. This happens repeatedly. Over succeeding generations, the gene for white fur spreads through the entire population of Arctic bears. The gene for dark fur loses out in the competition for survival. Mutations are entirely random and happen all the time, but the environment rewards those that increase the chance for survival. It naturally selects the living things that are better suited to survive. And that selection is the opposite of random. The two populations of bears separated and over thousands of years evolved other characteristics that set them apart. They became different species. That's what Charles Darwin meant by the origin of species.